Hi guys, this is Structures Explained, and in this video we'll be learning about raft foundations, also known as mat foundation. Later in this video we will talk about reinforcement used in them, so do watch the video till the end to get a better idea about raft foundations. Raft foundation is a type of shallow foundation which is a thick reinforced concrete slab spread over a large area of soil. It provides support for several columns and load-bearing walls. This type of foundation is provided when the column loads are heavy or the safe bearing capacity of soil is low. Rafts can have local thickenings or drops below columns. These thickenings are provided if the thickness of the raft is insufficient to bear shear and bending stresses. Rafts can also have beam embedded in them from column to column. These beams can be below, above, or hidden in the raft as per design requirements. These beams provide stiffness to the raft. This type of raft foundation is typically used when column loads are unequally distributed. Raft foundations can be combined with piles when more number of piles are closely spaced and the whole raft acts as a big pile cap. The piles transfer the load to the hard strata below them or via skin friction mechanism in absence of hard strata. Rafts take the load from the column or shear walls and transfer it to the soil below it. The load can be vertical, lateral, or a moment. In return, soil exerts a reaction force on the footing. This reaction and loads from above will generate stresses in the foundation, which will be resisted by concrete and reinforcement. Additionally, reinforcement prevents cracking of concrete due to shrinkage of concrete and temperature stresses. The deflected shape of the raft due to soil pressure looks approximately like the dashed lines. Now let us see the reinforcement distribution in the raft. For simplicity of understanding, we will only look at a part of the raft reinforcement. Starting from the bottom, rafts are provided with a mesh of rebars in both X direction and Y direction. Generally, bars in both directions have equal spacing and bar diameter, but may vary as per design and analysis requirements. Additional reinforcement, if required, is provided as a layer above the existing mesh. Usually, additional reinforcement is required below the column as positive bending moments are generated below them. Now let us see top reinforcement in the raft. Similar to the bottom, rafts are provided with a mesh of rebars in top, which run along both X direction and Y direction. Generally, bars in both directions have equal spacing and bar diameter, but may vary as per design and analysis requirements. Additional reinforcement, if required, is provided as a layer below the existing mesh. Usually, additional top reinforcement is required in the mid-spans as negative bending moments are generated on them. 90-degree hooks are provided at the ends of each rebar for sufficient anchorage with concrete. Shear reinforcement around the column can also be provided if the thickness of the raft is not sufficient to resist the shear. This shear reinforcement can be in the form of shear links or shear studs. They will resist the punching shear and keep the thickness of the raft less. A clear cover has to be left from top, bottom, and sides for the rebars. The value of cover is governed by site conditions and local codes. Cover on the foundations is on a higher side than other members of the structure as they are exposed to soil, chemicals, and water throughout their lifetime. Now let us talk about column reinforcement, which are embedded in the raft. The column longitudinal rebars start with a 90-degree hook in the raft for better anchorage with concrete. They are extended above the footing for sufficient lap length with main column reinforcement. If the above columns are of steel, the lap reinforcement is not needed. Lastly, we see stirrups, which start right from the bottom of the raft. They have a 135-degree hook, which is a must for columns. They tie the column longitudinal reinforcement and resist the shear forces in them. That's it for this video, guys. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. Comment below your thoughts, suggestions, or questions regarding this video. More such content will follow, so do subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon to get notified for new videos. Also check out our social media pages, links to which are in the description. Thanks for watching, see you in the next one.